Hi everybody, I hope you're all blessed and well in the Lord. In today's video, I wanted to share with you an update about the tree dream that I had. So I was watching a video from Born for Battle, and he had mentioned how this was going to be the year of the trees. And in my dream, I saw a large tree, and it was huge, like just like this, with the pool and then the person in the pool. And it seemed to be a silhouette of a woman. Also, I forgot to mention that. Okay, so I wanted to read a little bit about what the year of the trees is. Tu B'Shevat is a Jewish holiday occurring on the 15th day of the Hebrew month of Shevat. It is also called Rosh Hashanah, Layanat, literally New Year of the Trees. In contemporary Israel, the day is celebrated as an ecological awareness day, and the trees are planted in celebration. This begins February 9th, 2020. Okay, and the significance is the fruits that ripened from Tu B'Shevat on were counted for the following year's tithes. And it talks about bringing forth fruit. Okay. Then, I also received confirmation from Brother Stephen Corson. He said he had a dream of a tree with 12 fruits, and the leaves of the tree were for healing of the nations. So I thought that was awesome too. And I also got one more confirmation. Okay, and then I was texting Sister Kim Fisher, and she told me that she also had a dream of a big tree, and so this is her dream. She said, I was showing Brother Jared and Brother Todd a drawing of a tree Skylar had drawn, and the word Kodesh and Ruach. I was trying to explain to them that they needed to listen to what Skylar was telling us. So I looked up the meaning of those two names. The term in the Hebrew that is translated as Holy Spirit is Ha-Ruach Ha-Kodesh. The Spirit, or Ruach by itself, is the breath of Yahweh, which carries His life force, but not necessarily the presence of His person. And then if you go to the Strong's Concordance here, you see Ruach and Kodesh, they both refer to Yahweh. And then, so it means sacred, holy, Kodesh, one, saint, or set apart. Yeah, I thought that was pretty interesting. And then 2 days later, we were texting again. This was December 10th, and I was mentioning the dream of the falling star that I saw, and how it could be either the third or the fifth seal. And she was saying that it would have to be the third because of she said Revelation 4, doors open in heaven, and the voice of the trumpet is heard, and then that's when Jesus says, come up here, and he takes the bride. So this was literally December 10th. Then the very next day, I had a vision, and I had told her, and I said, Sis, I just had a vision just now. Before I woke up, I saw a two-door entrance swing open. And I sent her this picture to show her. So she was saying, maybe that's the Lord confirming this. So I thought that was pretty cool. And yeah, so this was December 11th, the morning of. I text her at, let's see, this was at 10:42 a.m. So, yeah, it's pretty awesome. I believe it's confirmation that Jesus is coming, and I'm going to share a few scriptures about the door being opened before I end this video. Revelation 3:7-8, and to the angel of the church of Philadelphia write, he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, who opens and no one will shut, and who shuts and no one opens, says this, I know your deeds. Behold, I have put before you an open door, which no one can shut, because you have a little power, and kept my word, and have not denied my name. Isaiah 22:22. Then I will set the key of the house of David on his shoulder. When he opens, no one will shut. When he shuts, no one will open. 1 Corinthians 16:9. For a wide door, effective service has opened to me, and there are many adversaries. 2 Corinthians 2:12. Now when I came to Troas for the gospel of Christ, and when the door was opened for me in the Lord. Isaiah 45:1. Thus says the Lord to Cyrus, his anointed, whom I have taken by the right hand to subdue nations before him, and to loose the loins of kings, to open doors before him, so that the gates will not be shut. Last but not least, Revelation 4:1. After this I looked, and behold, a door was opened in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was as it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show you these things which must be hereafter.